Come you buy the salmon fish, and come you buy the ropery. Saw you, my dear sailor laddie, sailing on the raging sea. I come buy the salmon fish, and I come buy the ropery. I saw your dear sailor laddie sailing on the deep blue sea. Come you buy the salmon fish, and come you buy the ropery. Join us at the Salmon Bothy every Friday virtually.
Hello, good evening, and welcome to Folk at the Salmon Bothy live on a Friday night. My name's Dick Elliott, or some of you might know me as Richard. I've been involved with Folk at the Salmon Bothy now for many years, and more than I care to remember. And although I don't live in Port Soy, I've always had a great affiliation with the place and with the music. So I'm speaking to you tonight from my garden here in Old Meldrum, and unfortunately for June it's not terribly warm, but yeah, hopefully the weather will pick up soon. So tonight would have been an interesting night for us at the Salmon Bothy, because tonight would have been the first night of our annual festival. We would have been celebrating the 11th occasion of the Hall, which is the music festival that we've been running for obviously 11 years, apart from this one. So it's a great sadness that it's not happening tonight. And we had a great lineup, and we'll talk a little bit about that lineup and how well it was going to be received, and how much we were looking forward to hearing tonight and over the next 3 days. So the haul is a fishing term that refers to the hauling of the nets, and we have used that term because of the association of Port Soy with the sea. But I actually live in Old Meldrum, and our association is with whisky, and you can see behind me our local distillery, which is rather close to where I live, and I can smell it as I'm walking down the street. Just now it smells quite good. It doesn't always smell that good, but just for now it's rather fine. So one of the songs tonight will have a whiskey flavour to it, and we'll explain that a little bit later on. Some of the acts you'll see tonight are maybe not quite so youthful now as they were when these videos were taken, and I'm sure you'll recognise yourself. You might need to add a few years. I'd include myself in that for sure. And one or two, sadly, are no longer with us, and we remember them fondly. I'm a whistle player, so there'll be a few tunes in tonight's selections, but there's plenty of songs and ballads and stories and poetry to get your teeth into as well. We'll find out how Albert has been doing, for example. Certainly towards the end, we have a bit of a montage of faces from previous festivals, which is worth staying on to watch right at the very end of the video. So without further ado, I'm going to exercise my host's privilege and play you a couple of tunes. These two tunes are both of Irish origin. The first one is called Cuz Tian's. There's lots of tunes attributed to Terry Tian, who's a famous player and composer and teacher. The second tune is called Her Long Hair Flowing Down, or Her Long Dark Hair Flowing Down, to be correct. I'm not too sure where the origin of that tune comes from, but I've learned it from sitting around in various sessions over the years and just picking up tunes. So here we go.
Thank you. So we're going to start our evening tonight with one of our regulars. This gentleman has been coming to the Salmon Bothy for a good number of years now, and sings unaccompanied and has become an established part of the Bothy Ballads tradition of the northeast of Scotland. Doug Hay, whom many of us will know, and he's going to sing a song about an item of clothing. Now, I'm clearly not from these parts, and it's taken me a long time to get the hang of the Doric. And don't worry, I'm not going to use any Doric on you tonight. But Nicky Tams is, it took me a long time to understand what your Nicky Tams were. And as you listen to this song, maybe you'll get the message yourself. And please don't go out without your Nicky Tams.
No, who's up there last week? Is a wee song for you, but then the first things I've ever learned, it's Nicky Tams. When I was only 10 years old, I left a pair of squeal. My father feed me to the mains, to chaw his milk and meal. I first put on my narrow bricks, to hide my spindle thrums. Sign a buckle to ruin my canopin' knees. A pair of Nicky Tams. First I get on for Bailey's loon, and second get on for third. And sign, of course, I had to learn the horseman's gripping word. A loaf of bread to be my piece, a bottle for drinking drams. But you canna go through the calfhouse door without your Nicky Tams. The farmer I am wi' the new, he's wealthy but he's mean. Though corn is cheap, his horse is thin, his harness fairly dean. He guards his load or kirts or foo, his conscience has nae qualms. Infant breeze straps brack, there's nothing like a pair of Nicky Tams. I'm courting bonny Annie New, Rob Thompson's catchy dame. She's but 45, and I'm just 17. She clorts a muckle piece to me, wi' different kinds of jam. And she tells me elke nicht that she admires my Nicky Tams. Well, I started off a Sunday aye, the kirkie for to young. My collar it was unke ticht, and my bricks was neen hour long. I hid my Bible in my pooch, likewise my book of Psalms. Fen Annie roared ye muckle gipe, take off your Nicky Tams. Though unca swear I took them off, the lassie for to please. But aye my bricks they lurk it up, I ruin about my knees. A wasp get crawling up my leg, in the middle of the Psalms. Oh, never again will I rig to the kirk without my Nicky Tams. I often thought I'd like to be a bobby on the force, or maybe I'd get on the cars and drive a pair of horse. But ever it is my lot to be the bobbies or the trams, I'll never forget those happy days I wore my Nicky Tams. There we go now. Keep safe, Abdi. We'll see you next time.
Kenny Spiers has been a guest at the Bothy on a number of occasions. He's a great singer and songwriter, and he's going to play a tune and a song that he wrote himself, and he's going to introduce it himself. So I'm just going to hand over to Kenny.
Hi everyone, this is Kenny Spiers here, and I'm going to do a song from my new CD, which is called New Dawn Breaking. There you go. And It's available on my website, kennyspiers.com. Hope to get up your way again sometime soon. The song's called I Just Don't Know. If you're looking for a reason for the turning of the seasons, I don't know, I don't know. If you can't understand why the sun keeps burning in the sky, I don't know, I don't know. Or if you can't explain the wind and the rain, or a falling flake of snow. If you ask of me why that should be, I don't know, I just don't know. If you want me to say why this world has lost its way, I don't know, I don't know. Or account for the mistakes our politicians make, I don't know, I don't know. When despite the proof, they deny the truth and then say it isn't so. If you ask of me why that should be, I don't know, I just don't know. No, I can't work out what it's all about. I don't know, I don't know. Why we laugh and we cry, people live and people die, I don't know, I don't know. Or why a true friend's smile makes it all worthwhile, the older that I grow. If you ask of me why that should be, I don't know, I just don't know. I don't know, I just don't know.
Another regular at Folk at the Salmon Bothy, Mr. Paul Kersley, is up next. Paul has a lovely, quiet manner as he plays and sings, so you might need to move your ear just a little bit closer to the screen for this one. Paul's going to give us a Bob Dylan classic. It's called Blind Willie McTell.
Ralph McTell, he came to Port Soy the other year thanks to the hard work of Bud Phillips. And it was great sitting listening to him. He was sort of reminiscing about his days around the Croydon area, the same era where I was brought up. And I could actually understand what he was saying. But his name McTell, he got from the blues singer Blind Willie McTell. And this is a Bob Dylan song, and it's called Blind Willie McTell. Thank you. Listen to me. I've seen the arrow on the doorpost, says this land is condemned, all the way from New Orleans to Jerusalem. I've traveled through dark places where many my axes fell. Ah, but I know no one can sing the blues like Blind Willie McTell. I heard that night bird calling as they were taking down the tent. The stars above and barren trees were the audience, and them charcoal gypsy maidens can strut their feathers well. Ah, but I know no one can sing the blues like Blind Willie McTell. See them big plantations burning, hear the cracking of the whip, smell them sweet magnolia blooming, the ghost of slavery sleep. I can hear them souls a-moaning, hear that undertaker's bell. Ah, but I know no one can sing the blues like Blind Willie McTell. There's a woman by the river with some fine young handsome man. He's dressed up like a squire, bootlead whiskey in his hand. And there's a chain gang on the highway, can you hear that rebel's yell? Ah, but I know no one can sing the blues in his heaven, and you all want what's his. But power and greed and corruptible seed seems to be all there is. I'm gazing out my window at the St. James Hotel. Ah, but I know no one can sing the blues like Blind Willie McTell. Yeah.
Next up we have John Dickson. John currently hails from Tarvis in Aberdeenshire. And has been a regular at Salmon Bothy for many years, and also at other folk clubs round about, and was one of our MCs last year and did a fine job, and told some really good jokes. One I particularly remember, and I'm sure he won't mind me giving away the punchline in a way, was about acoustic. If you remember that joke, John, well done, that's stuck in my mind. Tonight John's going to sing for us. He's going to sing a Richard Thompson song called Waltzing's for Dreamers. I could never understand waltzing myself. Three beats, two legs. Doesn't work for me, I'm afraid. But here we go. Waltzing's for Dreamers with John Dickson.
It's a song by Richard Thompson called Waltzing's for Dreamers. Play me a blues song, fade down the light. I'm as sad as a proud man could be sad tonight. Just let me dream on, just let me sway. while the sweet violins and the saxophones play. Oh, and miss, you don't know me. Oh, but can't we pretend that we care for each other till the band plays the end? One step for aching, two steps for breaking, waltzings for dreamers, losers in love. One step for sighing, two steps for crying, waltzings for dreamers, losers in love. They say love's for gamblers, the pendulum swing. I bet hard on love and lost everything. So don't send me home now, put a shot in my arm, and we'll drink to old memories, and we'll drink in the dawn. And Mr. Bandleader, won't you play one more time? I've got good folding money in this pocket of mine. One step for aching, two steps for breaking, waltzings for dreamers, losers in love. One step for sighing, two steps for crying, waltzings for dreamers, losers in love. One step for aching, two steps for breaking, waltzings for dreamers, losers in love. One step for sighing, two steps for crying, waltzings for dreamers, losers in love.
Our next act is one of John Dickson's co-conspirators. He was co-host of one of our concerts last year and did a grand job. Ron Gardner, multi-instrumentalist, really good fiddle player, singer, guitarist. Tonight he's going to sing a song by Adam McNaughton called Erchie Cathcart.
Well, I'll sing you a story o' Erchie Cathcart, a fella that I took good care o' his hurt. And I don't mean in terms o' romance and its issues. Erchie always took care to avoid fatty tissues. He read books on stress, and he read books on diet, and he made sure his hurt was well nourished and quiet. And when he found out that the fags were a threat, he said Erchie Cathcart smoked his last cigarette. And no just himsel he'd a smoke-free abode. Fags were banned fae his flat in Victoria Road. When his chain-smoking pal said that he'd been too hard on him, he said, you look after your own pericardium. On Glasgow's south side, the air does nae come near the EEC requirement for a clean atmosphere. So whenever he ventured outside o' his close, Cathcart wore a mask over his mouth and his nose, cause jogging was good for reducing your weight way. He jogged everywhere, even down to the gateway, where he bought low-fat milk and high-fibre bread, on loaves that are covered with caraway seed, and fresh fruit and veg, and when he had paid, he jogged away him with a bag on each side. When he heard o' the good-hearted Glasgow campaign, he signed up at once when he thought to delay, cause about his blood pressure he'd ne'er had a qualm, his height marked his weight to the last milligram. But the doctor consulting a chart on the wall said you're 2 points too high in your cholesterol. But there's no need to worry, just give up dessert. But I never eat pudding, said Archie Cuthcart. And he jogged away him in the depths of despair. After 10 years on muesli, what could he do mare? Then he read in the paper some scientists say your hurt can be helped by 2 aspirins a day. And the very next morning the Herald declared drinking wine with your meal can be good for your hurt. Eureka, cried Archie, the best way to beat 'em all is a wee glass o' buckfast and 2 paracetamol. But he thought since his whole life he'd aye been teetotal, 1 glass wouldna do, so he drank the whole bottle. Then on wi' his Reeboks downstair he did flee, right in front o' a bus, number 44B. It knocked him 6 metres, a terrible sight, but the autopsy showed his cholesterol was right. It was some consolation to his family physician that he died with his heart in such perfect condition. Now they say that small problems are sent here to try ye. They say that what's for ye will nae go by ye. If your name's on the bullet, ye will nae be spared. He was hit by a bus that was going to Cathcart.
Dave Goulder was on the Bothy Club stage a couple of years ago with Kenny Haddon and Dougie Mackenzie and a few others. And I was in the audience that night and had my camera phone with me and recorded this piece. So the quality is not great. But that's my fault, not Dave's, and the song is excellent. It's The Colours.
It's written around an old traditional rhyme that the novelist and poet Thomas Hardy tried in his old age to remember, couldn't quite remember it all, but got enough of it to put it together into a poem. And it was set to music by a classical composer who I know very little about, a man called Robin Milford, who was a friend of Paul Williams, a sort of minor composer. But he obviously had his feet firmly in the folksong scene in, well, it would have been the south of England, in Sussex and Hampshire. But I think this is a smashing song. It's called The Colours. What will I bring you, please, will white do? Best for your wearing the long day through. White is for weddings, weddings, weddings. White is for weddings. What will I bring you then, will red do? Best for your wearing the long day through. Red is for soldiers, soldiers, soldiers. Red is for soldiers, and that won't do. What will I bring you, please, will blue do? Best for your wearing the long day through. Blue is for sailors, sailors, sailors. Blue is for sailors, and that won't do. What will I bring you then, will green do? Best for your wearing the long day through. Green is for mayings, mayings, mayings. Green is for mayings, and that won't do. What will I bring you then, will black do? Best for your wearing the long day through. Black is for mourning, mourning, mourning. Black is for mourning, and black will do.
John Mackie, sadly no longer with us, but a renowned poet in his day, and created some wonderful works, particularly the one about the spey, the mouth of the spey. Really beautiful. The rhythm and watching him perform was a real treat. So tonight we've dipped into the archive and we're going to bring you a poem from John, a poem about a Keith Floyd recipe. And the backing of this is by Northern Shore.
Company in this first one. Have lots of mouth plate floss to the festival. It's in Spanish. It's about a recipe by Keith Floyd. Called Conejo con Higos con Rioja. Onto the rabbit. It took us all day to perfect that taste in Capriera. Flicking his spoon at the stubborn snow, flecking the heads of the Sierra Nevada.
So we've come to the end of part one, and we're just going to bring you up to the interval with another regular from the Hall Festivals. This is Dougie Mackenzie, and Dougie's going to sing for us The Wild Rover.
Wild Rover. I've been the Wild Rover for many years. I spent all my money on whiskey and beer, but now I'm returning with golden great thorn. I swear I won't play the Wild Rover
I swear I will.
eyes, Bob and the white will light. Oh, my hand, good to see. Oh, I've went all the best. And the words that I spoke of them never would be less. While the Roman, I swear I will play lover and rover. I have gone mad to my parents, I confess what I even am. Well, I'll ask them to pardon their promise. Undoubtedly, embrace me as one time before. I swear I will claim love and rover. Wild and rover, wild and rover, wild and rover. I swear I will claim love and rover.
Welcome back to part two. Again, exercising my host privileges, I'm going to give you a couple of tunes. These are from a set of five. I'm not going to play all five, don't worry. But these are known colloquially as the Shetland Five. And they're generally played, let's say, considerably faster than I'm going to give you them tonight. The first tune is called Jack Broke the Prison Door, and the second tune is Donald Blue. I guess it's no secret that I really enjoy playing in a session. The whistle can be a lonely instrument playing on your own, and it's great to be in the company of others and to have a few good tunes. So with that in mind, and again digging into our archive, here is a session from the Shore Inn, or Shoreys as we know it, from one of our previous festivals, and in this you'll hear Geordie Murison. And he'll be singing a couple of songs. You'll hear The Gaddy Runs, Gin I Were But The Gaddy Runs, and you'll also hear The Barnyards of Delgatay. And quite a few of our session regulars are folk club members and will often be heard playing in the Salmon Bothy. So sit back and enjoy a wee bit of pub culture. It's the nearest you're going to get to a pub this week.
I'm not afraid of the dark.
The Spiers family have been supporters of Folk at the Salmon Bothy since day one, and what a tremendous amount of work and effort they put in behind the scenes, and we thank them for that. Tonight you're going to hear a song sung by Tom. It's probably one of my favourites, although I think I prefer it when Emma sings it, but you know, beggars can't be choosers. So here is the stoutest man in the 42 with the Spiers family.
Behold, I am a soldier old, and only 25 years old. A finer warrior ne'er was seen fae Inverness to Gretna Green. When I was young, my father said he'd bid me to a decent trade, but I didna like the work of a', say, a kid in a giant, the 42. Well, the wind may blow, the fog may grow, the rain may rain, and the snow may snow. You winna fret and joke may grow. This stoutest man in the 42. The sergeant finlisted me, he slapped me back, and then said he, a man like you, so big and tall, could ne'er be killed by a cannonball. The colonel then, when he come roon, he's looked me up and he's looked me down. He's winked at me and said, I guess ye must be the beastie fae Loch Ness. Well, the wind may blow, the cock may crow, the rain may rain, and the snow may snow. You winna fret and joke may grow, the stoutest man in the 42. Last faked we had o'er the sea, the general Manny sent for me. When I got there with my big gun, the battle was as good as won. For the enemy are run away, and the saddest sighs a joke me grow. A man like me, so big and neat, ye ken yoursel could ne'er be beat. Well, the wind may blow, the cock may crow, the rain may rain, and the snow may snow. Ye winna fret and joke may grow, the stoutest man in the 42. The king he held a grand review, we numbered 1,062. The Kelty lads come marching past, and Joke McGrath come marching last. The royal party grabbed their sticks, and I began to stretch their necks. The king, he said, why bless my soul, I thought that man was a telegraph pole. Well, the wind may blow, the cock may crow, the rain may rain, and the snow may snow. You winna fret and joke may grow, the stoutest man in the 42.
So over the last few weeks of our Friday nights with Folk at Salmon Bothy, we've been hearing about the life and times of Albert. And I first came across Albert in a session in Tarland, strangely. One of the chaps there was able to recite Albert, the lion. But tonight, Paul Mudie is going to bring us up to date. And tonight we're going to hear about Albert and the recumbent posture.
Hello again, and welcome to another week of finding out what Albert's up to. We're in the wee house today, and as you can see, we've got all mod cons, which is a bit of a problem because it doesn't encourage me to get out of bed early in the morning to get started on the wee house, on the big house, which means perhaps that's why it's taken a bit of a long time. But somebody else who was stuck in bed was Albert. The day after Christmas, young Albert were what's called confined to bed, with a tight kind of pain in his stomach and a light feeling up in his head. His parents were all of a fluster when they saw little lad was so sick. They said, "Put out your tongue." And when they'd seen it, they said, "Put it again, away again, quick." Ma made him a basin of gruel. But that were a move for worse. Though the little lad tried hard to eat it, at the finish he did just the reverse. That pain showed no signs of abating, so at last they got doctor to call. He said it were in the abdomen and not in the stomach at all. He sent up a bottle of physic with instructions on the label to say, "To be taken in a recumbent posture, 1 teaspoon 3 times a day. As Ma stood there reading the label, Pa started to fidget about. He said, "Get a teaspoon and dose him before he gets better without." "I can manage teaspoons," said Mother, a look of distress on her face. "It's this here recumbent posture. I haven't got one in the place." Said Pa, "What about Mrs. Lupton? Next door here. You'd better ask her. A woman who's buried 3 husbands is sure to have one of them there." So they went round and asked Mrs. Lupton. "Aye, I know what you mean," she replied. "I had one on order for Horace, but poor dear got impatient and died." She said "You'd best go and try Co-op shop. They'll have one in stock, I dare say. Fact, I think I saw one in Winder last time I was passing that way." So round they went to Co-op shop, and at a counter for household supplies, Pa asked for a recumbent posture, and the shopman said, "Yes, sir, what size?" Said Ma, "It's for our little Albert. I don't know what size he would use. I know he takes 13 in collars and 6 wide fittings in shoes." "Aye, if it's little lad's size you're as wanting," said the shopman, "I'm sorry to say. We know what Bad had one in building, and that one was sold yesterday." He sent him across to Tinsmith, who said, "Ooh, I know what you've got in mind. If you'll draw me a pattern, I'll make me one." But Pa left his pencil behind. By trade, every shop they could think of. They walked for 2 hours by clock. And though most places reckoned to keep them, they'd none of them got one in stock. The last place they tried was chemist, who looked at them both with a frown and told them that a recumbent posture were Latin and meant lying down. "Ah, it means lying down in Latin," said Father. "That's just what I thought." Then he picked up a side glance from Ma and wished he hadn't said nowt. "They're not dosing my lad with Latin," said Mother, her face looking grim. "Just plain castor oil's all he's getting, and I'm leaving posture to him." "Well, keep safe, and we'll see you another week."
Our next act is yet another folk at the Salmon Bothy regular, Mike Blackburn. Mike is a singer, songwriter, guitarist, and has been putting these videos together, and we thank him for that. Tonight he's going to sing for us one of his own compositions. It's called The Hunter's Moon.
So, I had not done this for a few years. Hunter's Moon. Will you not take heed, listen to my story? Should you be a man well along in years? If you take a wife who is young and pretty, it can never end but in blood and tears. Oh, I curse my age and my lack of wisdom, and I curse the day I became a groom. But the thing I swear was my ready downfall was that I was wed under the hunter's moon. For so many years I was quite contented, then my own sweet love laid her eyes on me. Like a hound I chased and I did pursue her, till the trap was sprung and I could not break free. Oh, the sun it rose for our autumn wedding, and we pledged our vows just before the noon. But the feasting done and the party over, took we to our bed beneath the hunter's moon. Like a day, the light shone through our window when we closed the door to our bridal room. And we gave to each other so gladly, and the beams fell in from the hunter's moon. And when I awoke, she was not beside me, though the bed was warm where my wife had lain. So I raised myself and crossed to the window, where I saw my love as she walked away. Gently then I stole after my beloved, followed as she danced to a silent tune, to the very place we had done our courting, in the meadow bright beneath the hunter's moon. So I watched her quiet as she let her hair down, and she sweetly smiled as she danced around. Slipping up her shoes in the quiet meadow, carefully she folded her bridal gown. So my heart was pierced that she proved unfaithful, that she little cared for a vow so soon. And my tears spilled down as my poor heart promised she would never see another hunter's moon. And by a haystack there lay a pitchfork, and I strode to stand by my lying wife. So I pinned her through her faithless body, in the lonely meadow I took her life. Never sound she made, nor a cry for mercy, but a hand she raised till it touched my own. And her eyes met mine as the life it left her, as I dropped her hand with no mercy shown. So I walked away from her naked body, with a heavy heart at my misfortune. And I slowly came to a house of mourning, now that she was dead under a hunter's moon. But when I returned to the bridal chamber, and I fell headlong on our marriage bed, as I wept and cursed for my own misfortune, there I found a note lying by my head. Oh, my love, my lord, and my only master, do you come across to the meadow soon? For I long to kiss and caress my husband in the waxing light of the hunter's moon. Now I lie in jail waiting for the hang, and I hang my head in my lonely room, but I soon will ask for my love's forgiveness. I shall never know another hunter's moon. Hunter's Moon. Thanks very much.
So next up, we've got another tune for you, this time from Debbie Mudie. Debbie's going to play a tune called Jenny Jones. I think it might sometimes be called Sweet Jenny Jones. And Debbie plays the recorder.
Hi, Debbie here. This is a wee tune called Jenny Jones, and it again is from that Celtic book. There you go, that's it for this week. See you next time. Take care, everybody. Bye now.
Lord Franklin was an intrepid English explorer who allegedly once had to eat his boots. Must have been pretty hungry. Tonight, another intrepid explorer, a musical explorer, Bob Sharp, is going to bring you that sailor's tune, or sailor's ballad, The Lord Franklin.
The song tells the story of one Lord Franklin who set out to find the Northwest Passage and failed, basically. It wasn't until some years later that John Ray from Orkney was the man that actually found the Northwest Passage, and so the history books were put straight. But however, this is Lord Franklin. I dreamed a dream and I thought it true, concerning Franklin and his gallant crew. With 100 seamen he sailed away to the frozen ocean in the month seek that passage around the pole, where we poor sailor men do sometimes go. Through cruel hardships he vainly strove, His ship on mountains of ice was there, where the Eskimo and their skin canoe were the only thing that ever did come through. In Baffin's Bay, where the whalefish do blow, the fate of Franklin no man can know. The fate of Franklin no man can tell. Lord Franklin alone with the sailor man to dwell. Now my cruel burden my long lost Franklin, I would cross the main. 10,000 pounds I would freely give to know on earth that my Franklin did live. Franklin.
Another club regular this time, Julianne Wall. Junie has been coming to the club for quite a few years now and often sings unaccompanied English folk songs. Tonight she's going to sing a song of her own composition and it's called This Day.
There's a story behind this song. It's not my usual format to write soppy love songs. But I've written a couple. And these were written, well, this one that I'm about to play was written back in the 80s when I was in my late 20s. And my parents were running a wedding video business. And every bit of copyright music that the brides wanted on there had to be paid for. So in order to keep the costs down, they were given the option of using some of my songs for free as background music. So they were tailored to, specifically to a bride's wedding day, obviously. So, you know, a little bit soppy. But so this one is called This Day. Only lovers know.
our penultimate act this evening, three fine gentlemen who have supported the folk club through many years. That's Shepheard, Speirs and Watson. Tonight they're going to sing us a song called The Maskin Rung. I had to look this up, to be fair. The Maskin Rung is a stick. It's a long wooden pole that was used for stirring the malt in a whiskey distillery. So hence my reference to the distillery a little bit earlier on. So here we are with a slightly different use for the Maskin Rung with Shepheard, Speirs and Watson.
A fair maid she gaed oot tae tae, tae milk her feathers kye. A young man he come efter her and followed her speedily. And the holland grouse, and the holland grouse, the holland grouse sae green. And there's nae tree in a' the wood like the birk in the holland green. Had off your hands, young man, she says, had them off of me. And it's in a place in the gay green wood, a morn I'll meet with thee. And the holland grouse, and the holland grouse, the holland grouse sae green. And there's nae tree in a' the wood like the birk in the holland green. She's teen her milk pail in her hand, she's gaed singing hame, and she's thocht her a' that lee lang nicht, for she would beguile the young man.
And the holland grouse, and the holland grouse, the holland grouse sae green. And there's nae tree in a' the wood like the birk in the holland green.
So she's gin tae a wooda wife, she's borrowed a suit o' clies, and she's busket them on the maskin rung, a wat o' the greenwood gaze. And
the holland grouse, and the holland grouse, the holland grouse sae green. And there's nae a tree in a' the wood like the birk in the holland green.
The young man he come through the wood, he whistled and he sang. Oh, I see that my true love loves me weel, she has nae tarried long.
The holland grouse, and the holland grouse, the holland grouse sae green. And there's nae a tree in a' the wood like the birk in the holland green.
But wonder what does ail my love, for oh, but she is meek. At his eyes she looks into my face, but ne'er a word to speak.
And the holland grouse, and the holland grouse, the holland grouse sae green. And there's nae a tree in a' the wood like the birk in the holland green.
He's lifted up her petticoat a bit above the knee, but there's nothing there but the maskin rung, and the fair maid is away.
The holland grouse, and the holland grouse, the holland grouse sae green. And there's nae a tree in a' the wood like the birk in the holland green.
Oh, a fast maid has been my true love, fast has she been to me. But if I had her in the gay green wood, she wouldna ging a maiden free.
And the holland grouse, and the holland grouse, the holland grouse sae green. And there's nae a tree in a' the wood like the birk in the holland
green.
So I hope you've enjoyed our little wander through the archive and our contributions from our regulars. We're going to bring the evening to a close now with some more memories of the Hall Festivals. These Friday night programmes wouldn't be possible without lots of work going on behind the scenes, and I think everyone who's involved in that deserves some thanks. Thank you very much. And we are always looking for more material, and we do not require hugely technical or enormously complicated compositions. You can do as I'm doing tonight and sit down in your living room in front of your camera phone and record yourself and send it in, and we will use it. We were definitely looking for contributions from current members, past members, guests, and friends of folk at the Salmon Bothy. So thank you again for listening, and we're going to play you out tonight with a montage of photographs from previous halls. You'll recognise lots of people in these photographs, and some of them have advanced their years somewhat since the photos were taken. I certainly have. And the music underneath is again from the Spiers family, and was recorded at a sing-around in the hotel in Portsoy, and is a very fitting piece of music, I think you'll agree. So thank you very much for listening. It's been a pleasure to speak to you tonight, and I hope to see you at the Salmon Bothy at some time in the future. Good night.
It's a song.